Hello, my loves, it's Monica, and today I am so excited because I'm going to be sharing with you all some cozy Nintendo Switch games that are going to be coming out in the next year or so. E3 has been happening over the past few days, and there have been lots of game previews and announcements that have just got me so excited. But not all of the games that I'm going to be talking about in this video are ones that were announced at E3. That's just sort of what inspired this. But yeah, I'm so excited to share all these games with you guys. And if you have any games that you're really excited for, please let me know in the comments so that I can put it on my radar and we can all be excited together. But without further ado, let's dive on into the games. The first game I want to talk about has been very much so high on my wish list ever since I first heard about it, and that is Coral Island. This game is inspired by classic farming sim games, except it's set on an island in Southeast Asia. And I also really love that the studio that's developing the game is also based in Indonesia, and so many of the developers are Southeast Asian. I just think that's really awesome. So right off the bat, when I saw this game, I loved how diverse the cast was. Everyone just looks amazing. Like, the art style is so cool, and I love the specific like setting. So along with your sort of classic farming sim capabilities, so like building relationships, farming, mining, all of that, you also like have the coral reef that you can explore and you're like cleaning it up. So environmentalism is definitely a big part of the game, which I also really love. But yeah, this one just sounds amazing, and all of the videos that I've seen for it just look so fun. Like, I cannot wait to get my hands on it. And it's supposed to be releasing, I think, late this year. Fingers crossed. The next game is supposed to be coming out sometime in fall, and that is Lake. And this one sounds so fun. Basically, it seems like a Lifetime movie, but as a video game. You play as Meredith, who has like been living in the big city, and she decides to quit her corporate job and she goes back to her hometown, where she begins a new life as a mail carrier. And in her town, she gets to meet all the people who live there and build relationships, I assume have a romance. So yeah, it just sounds really cute. And I love, like, even the trailer, if you go watch the trailer, they like got someone to do a voiceover for it that like literally sounds like the kind of voiceover that you would hear in a like rom-com, for a rom-com type of film. Yeah, I just think this one is going to be a fun, cute, cozy time. For sure. So this next game I wasn't even going to include in this list because I feel like I've been hearing about this game for years without any sort of like solid update on when it was coming out. But I googled it right before filming, and apparently there is like a demo that's out, or it's coming out in like the next few days. So like, it's actually real, and that is Little Witch in the Woods. Ugh, I am so excited for this game. It looks so lovely. You're basically a novice witch. You're living in the woods. You're living your day-to-day life as a witch, learning how to be a witch. Obviously, it's got a lot of those farming simulator elements, but like with that added addition of like magic. And that added addition of magic is what really makes me so excited for this one. It just looks so whimsical and fun. I'm nervous that maybe my expectations are too high for it because I've been so excited for so long, but regardless, cannot wait to pick this one up. And I believe it's coming out either later this year, like fully, or early next year. Now moving on to the next game, which is Grow Song of the Evertree. And this one is brought to you by the same studio that created Yonder, which I have not played. Should I play it? Let me know. It's been on my wish list for ages. It looks lovely. But yeah, it's brought to you by the same studio, and it just looks stunning. In this one, you're an alchemist caring for a magical tree that grows worlds on its branches. With your alchemy, you nurture these floating islands and build towns to house the characters who live on the tree. Love that it's like a combination of an adventure game, life management game, and like world crafting game. So, you know, you have puzzles to solve, caves to explore, fish to catch, and this one in particular obviously sounds like a great one for people who have played Yonder, but also Animal Crossing, and I can't wait to get my hands on it. Another game that I feel like I've been waiting years for is another game that I feel like I've been waiting years for is Mineko's Night Market. This is a social sim adventure game where you craft, farm, and interact with lots of cats on a Japanese-inspired island. You play Mineko, who is new to the island, and each week there's a night market. And to prep for that, you go on quests and craft items. Then during the market, you get to sell those items in order to earn income, but also compete in a variety of games like themed parades, cat racing, and stage performances. I think this one looks fantastic for, obviously, if you like farming sim kind of games. Kind of also gives me like Cozy Grove vibes, but yeah, it just looks lovely. There's also a cat god named Abe. Love that. Then there's a game called Letters that just looks super interesting, and unlike anything I've personally played before, it's a coming of age word puzzle game where you play as Sarah, who is a shy girl from Switzerland, and through her letters and text messages you end up interacting with and meeting her friends and getting to know her life, and also getting to help her make decisions to sort of path or find like her path forward in life. So this one looks very emotional and very narrative focused, and I also love the whole addition of like word riddles. I love a good riddle. So yeah, I think I'll have a lot of fun with this one, but I also feel like this one will make me a little emo, so we'll see how it goes. Then there's Hoa, and Hoa is a puzzle platforming game that gives me major Studio Ghibli vibes. For one, the art style. It actually features a lot of hand-drawn or hand-painted artwork throughout the game, and I think that really gives me that sort of Ghibli atmosphere. Honestly, everything about this game, from the score to the magical creatures, just seems delightful. And the other thing that kind of gives me Studio Ghibli vibes is the sort of focus on like the simple joys of life. So you're playing like the game through the eyes of a child, and it's, you know, the puzzles or the gameplay itself is supposed to be like very relaxing but still compelling, like getting you want to move forward. But still chill enough to like have those cozy vibes. But yeah, the whole point of the game is to like explore these little wonders. Then there is Omno, and the best word I can think of to describe this game is dreamy. In this one, you are swept away to a world of wonder that is full of puzzles, secrets, and obstacles. Honestly, after watching some of the gameplay videos of this one, I am most excited to fly. I think there's a reason why they show so much of it in the trailer. It just looks truly so beautiful. Then Outer Wilds is coming to the Switch this summer, which I'm so excited for, because this one has been out for other consoles for a while, and I've had my eye on it for a little while. I've been really wanting to play it, so I'm so excited to finally be able to get it on my Switch. And in this one, you play as an archaeologist who is stuck in a solar system that's like stuck in an endless time loop, basically, and your goal is to try and get out of that time loop and to get time to move forward again. So you have to explore all these different worlds, understand like all this different alien tech, and as you uncover and learn more about the lore of the world, you learn how to fix your problem. So yeah, I've heard that this one, especially like the lore, is just so well done, and I love that feeling of like discovering in games. That's like one of my favorite things to do in games, so I'm really excited for that, and it looks so beautiful. These next couple of games are all 2022 except for one, which is I have no idea. So the first 2022 release is Rune Factory 5, and would you believe it, I've actually never played a Rune Factory game before. I was going to buy 4, and then I saw 5 was coming out, so I was like, well, I'll just wait for 5, but I'm impatient, so I'm like, maybe I'll just get 4 because it sounds really fun. So let me know, should I get Rune Factory 4? Leave me a comment. But Rune Factory, if you are also unfamiliar like I was, it's kind of like this really amazing combination of a bunch of different game genres. You have a farming sim, social sim, and an action combat role-playing game all in one. And I guess in each game you start off having lost your memories, so you take up a whole new life while trying to recover them. In this one you end up in a land that is blessed by nature, not sure what that means, but you end up joining this like a group of peacekeeping rangers. And yeah, I don't know. I've just been really intrigued to try out Rune Factory because it's always been recommended to me. So many of you recommended it to me in the comments of my last Cozy Games video. So is it time? Should I finally play it? Let me know. The next 2022 release is Cat Cafe Manager, and honestly, the title says it all. I really don't have much else to add. You basically are a cat cafe manager, so you get to decorate and build your cafe and serve patrons. You get to adopt cats and also like build out and expand your cafe as you become more and more successful. Pretty simple, but also sounds fantastic. I actually can't go to cat cafes because I am allergic to cats, which is devastating to me, by the way. Yeah, I'm allergic. It's a sad time. So this is like the next best thing. I get to be in a cat cafe on my Switch. Finally, this last one, I don't have a release date at all for it. I'm gonna assume the next couple of years, maybe? I don't know, but it's Witchery Academy, and this one is you're literally an apprentice witch at an academy. These last two ones are really straightforward. Honestly, it just looks really cute, and I love the idea that like you actually have classes that you can attend and like learn your witchcraft at. I think that sounds really fun, and you can also like explore the academy itself. So yeah, I'm excited for that one. I don't really know much about it, but it sounds potentially like a really fun time. So yeah, those are some games that I cannot wait to get on my Switch. Also, I get a lot of questions about my Switch and how it's pink. This is just a sticker. I got it from Sticky Bunny Co. and then I put a case on it that I got from Amazon. But yeah, the sticker I just stuck on myself. It was a very stressful experience, I'll be honest, but I used a hair dryer and that helped me like smooth out all the lumps and bumps, and I'm really happy with how it turned out. This has been on it for quite a while and it's still going strong. So yeah, that's why my Switch is like pastel purpley pink. But anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I would love to hear from you all what of these games you're most interested in or what games you're most excited for that I missed. And I will talk to y'all next time. Bye!